now?
Hey, bro.
Okay.
How are you?
Long time. Good.
Good.
Your picture? Oh.
Oh. Naughty Kelly. I've been working for JRT for about a year and a half now, and one thing that never changes is there's always something new going on. Wow. We show up this time and there's an F1 paddock area that's insane. It's the size of a small home. There's a test track that me and the team get to go practice on to improve our driving skills. At the beginning of the season, we talked about building a circle track so that way me and the rest of the team, Boss, Johnny, Deerman, everybody could go out there and put some laps down, and it's literally right on the other side of the shop, so we pull the cars out. We just need to do a quick shakedown on them without hitting some big jumps and wearing all the parts out. We just want to go and shake it down right before it gets on the boat and heads out to the race. Boss's car has been built for a while now, and it's a fast, reliable car, just trying to make it even faster every chance we get. We made some pretty big gear changes to Boss's car and actually changed the cam and the motor and some spindles in the front, some suspension things. So we're going to go test a couple things on the circle track, see how the gearing is. So I'm the lucky guy that gets to go test them all. They're just extremely fast and full drive, so it makes a lot of fun to back them in and drive them pretty aggressively. Yesterday, I was out there with Johnny and I hopped in the passenger seat. And actually, I found a couple things that he could improve on. He did it, got a faster lap time. I learned a couple things as well, sitting in the passenger seat. Things that he would do to shorten up the track and stuff like that. And it's just awesome to go out there with your team and learn a bunch of stuff.
Okay?
Okay.
Usually, we're so busy working on the new cars that my car doesn't really get any love, but it was pretty cool to see that race put some work into it. And so my car's got some upgrades, new cage, new motor, new front sway bar, but the coolest thing about it is this little red switch right here, but I'm pretty sure it adjusts the boost. It's got a little red cover, flip it up. I think it's my ghost fast switch, I'm pretty sure. Anto, you didn't touch the red switch, have you? No? Hey, no. So we showed up here yesterday and this thing was freaking set up in front of the shop. I guess this is gonna be the new hospitality area for the pits. It looks like this was like a BMW F1 team that owned this one. It's pretty nuts. We weren't here when they set it up, but I'm guessing it probably takes a good 2 days just to set it up. That looks like you can set some TVs up here and have some race videos going on, some music. Let's take a look back here. I think this is where the kitchen is. It's pretty insane. I don't even have a kitchen like this in my house. It's pretty crazy how much goes into this, into our racing over here. This is my quad ski. Take that out on Wednesdays. My four-seater so I can take the family out. And then we got my race rigs over here. You know, these two-seater 1000s. There's a pretty cool company over in England, Bowler Industries, and they make some really cool Range Rover style cars. I think they race desert with them or whatever, but Boss ordered a couple of them for over here, and they didn't do too good on our style of racetrack. I think maybe too many big jumps and stuff like that, but man, they make a hell of a daily driver. It's all, the whole body's carbon fiber. I'd for sure have one if I could. It's basically a race car with AC. I feel like I'm selling cars now. Out here at IXOR round 4. So when we got here the first half of the day, they're still getting the track dialed in, so it gave us some more downtime. There's actually a local little dirt bike track that we went and threw down some laps. It was pretty fun. I borrowed one of the policemen's helmets and threw that on, and I think Anung and one of his buddies were out, and Jeremy were out battling with them, and it was actually a lot of fun. There's three of us just throwing passes on each other and having a good time, and that's what it's all about here in Indo. Here in about a month, and which is crazy for Indonesia. Usually rains every day or every other day, so the track's a lot different, a lot more dusty. We're changing up the setups and gearing and just checking over the cars, making sure everything's dialed in for tomorrow's day one of racing.
He always do the best.
Thanks, dude. He's just saying that because I'm right here right now. That's my co-driver. Five cars on our team and everyone went out flawless today. So how'd you feel about today's dust, Reese?
You know, the dust was out of control. Cars running good, but you couldn't really see what was going on because there's so much damn dust. It hadn't rained in like a month.
How you feel about today and all the dust?
It's awesome in my eyes.
How was today's little rip?
Nice, but debunya gila.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who do you think's gonna win tomorrow?
Saya pikir bos, saya dan bos yang menang.
Yeah, he said definitely Doug McTagg's got it tomorrow, so thanks, man.
Okay.
Thank you. Are you going to win tomorrow, buddy? Yeah, that's a yeah. He's going to win. Great interview. Who do you think's going to win tomorrow? Rolling. Recording.
Whoa, crazy. Gila, bro.
Recording.
Hey, bro. Sekuat tenaga kita harus mengalahkan Dogi. Kalau Dog sih bukan payah lagi ya. Dia crazy. Gila, bro.
What kind words from Atoy. He's such a nice guy to say that I'm just going to beat everyone tomorrow. I'm just getting so much support out here. Thank you, Atoy.
Okay, thanks
for the
bro.
Kind words, buddy. Yeah. five of us on the team, and it actually me and Johnny both had a pretty scary first round. My car shut off in my first round and got it going and ended up with a decent time, about 10 seconds slower than I wanted it to be. And then Johnny had a tumble. He actually rolled the car in the first run, set him back a little bit, but both of us pulled it together for the second run, was able to put down really quick times and put us back on the top of our classes. The format for racing here in Indonesia is quite a bit different. There's four times that you go out in a weekend, and all your times are added together, which gives you a final time at the end of the weekend. And if you have one bad race, like a DNF, your car breaks, you roll, something to where you can't get to the finish line, or you get to the finish line way too late, really screws you for the whole weekend. The biggest thing when you're racing is not only to try to be fast, but you have to be really safe. You have to make sure the car makes it there to the finish line every time. It's a big mind game when you're out there to make sure that you make it around the track fast, and not only fast, but safe.
Oke, hari ini udah hari kedua untuk perlombaan Speed Off Road 2015 ini. Sekarang udah pukul 8. Nah, saya SS3-nya itu nanti jam 9.44. Berhubung mobil saya juga masih rusak untuk gardan depannya, tapi tidak masalah karena kita sekarang udah mendatangkan spare partnya dari Batu Licin, dikirim pakai jet. Terus kita hanya punya waktu mungkin kurang lebih 1.5 jam lagi untuk persiapan, tapi boleh bilang tidak masalah, dia akan bisa cepat untuk menyelesaikannya, dan semoga bisa selesai dan saya juga bisa gas full lagi. Terima kasih JRT. Oke. Thanks.
Crazy. Gila, bro.
Oh iya.
Pale apa nih tadi nih?
Recording.
Hey, bro.
We make driver run faster. Cool shirt. I'm not really sure what that means. Do you know what it means? I've been coming to Indonesia and Yeah, but what would you call that? What's that word? My problem is I always think so far ahead of what I'm going to say that I don't focus on what I'm saying now. I'm trying to say the
You threw me off when you
said what am I? I'm trying to say, like, there's always They think you just come in here and ruin our interview.